is where the party ends. I can't stand here listening to you and your racist friend.
This is something that has been annoying me for a very long time.
Dear Lord, you sound exactly like a young Jeff Daniels.
Not only as a console gamer, and a devoted one at that.
Devotion to the console or devotion to the gaming?
And not only as a more casual PC gamer, but as a gamer in general.
You got consoles, you play on PC, gotcha. Gamer in general.
What am I talking about here? The quote-unquote PC master race.
If you're going to say quote-unquote, you don't have to do the quotes with your fingers.
Trend of gamers that has been going around the internet for about 3 to 4 years.
Five. 5 years a week ago, actually. Good timing.
Every time I see some narcissistic douchebag PC gamer go up where they shouldn't be.
Up where they shouldn't be. There's just places that a PC gamer shouldn't be. There's no places where the master race does not belong, yeah? We will extend to the ends of the earth.
And just try to make themselves be the superior one? It's cringy.
I will consider you a connoisseur in the field.
You don't come off as superior, okay?
You know, it's almost like that's the point of the joke.
You come off as a narcissistic and egotistical douchebag.
Narcissistic and egotistical?
Wow, you can play games better than I can. Good job, do you want a fucking cookie?
Yes.
But anyways, what else do I feel?
It's like, what else do I feel? I don't know. I can't hold all these feelings that I have. Give me a moment so I can think about how I feel on this topic.
About PC Master Race. Well, I can tell you a lot of things. PC gamers, they have their advantages. They do get higher frame rates and better graphics depending on if they have better parts. But
you and I both know that anybody who plays games on a PC and uses it as his hobby will have better parts than an Xbox or a PlayStation.
I mean, it's their business. I mean, if they prefer PC gaming to console gaming, then that's fine. That's not the problem. The problem is their attitude.
I guess you can let anything bother you if you want it to.
I never had this problem towards PC gamers. Just the narcissistic ones, alright?
Listen, just because I'm handsome and charming and witty, clever and intelligent and fit, healthy, well endowed, that doesn't mean I'm narcissistic. Oh, and humble. I forgot that. I'm humble.
But what PC Gaming Master Race really spells to me is racism.
Normally, once somebody calls you a racist, that means you've won the argument, but I'm intrigued. Do go on.
This is the gaming equivalent of racism. You can't deny it.
I deny it.
The PC Master Race logo should just have a big old Confederate flag on it, if you ask me.
Ah, the Confederate flag stands for literally racism now. Okay. Also, nobody asked you.
So why do I think this? Well, I plotted out some points for you guys, because in my commentaries, that was a problem for some people.
What? Problems with your commentaries? No.
You don't have points! Well, I got three of them right here, bitch. Alright, let's see the first one. Okay, they single out a group of weaker individuals.
We draw that distinction because there is an actual objective measurement by which you can tell the strength of something. Consoles have very underpowered hardware compared to a gaming PC. We could match RAM for RAM, GPUs to GPUs, teraflops to teraflops. We can put our benchmarks next to each other and see who's just bigger.
And they single these as inferior gamers just by their looks. What do I mean by this? So, console games might not look as advanced, the graphics might not look as advanced as PC games. So what does the PC Gaming Master Race do?
This is why I don't sit in front of a webcam.
They single out the console gamers as inferior gamers. They single them out as inferiors just because the console games don't look as nice, or they look different from the PC games.
Different as in worse. No, PC gamers do not single out console gamers. And we don't think that console gamers are lesser human beings or worse people because their hardware is worse and their games look worse. I've said it before and I've said it again. PC gamers aren't better people, we just have better toys.
Now let's go back to the Civil War.
Oh boy.
and that time in the United States. What did we do?
Whoa. Hold on. What's with the we? I was born in 1992. That's not all that long ago. I wasn't alive during those days, and I will not be held responsible, nor will I be lumped in with anybody else who is responsible for anything good or bad that was done back then. Fun fact, I do share a birthday with Abraham Lincoln. I know it's popular with the young people to constantly demonize America's past, but I wasn't alive back then, so I'm not going to be held responsible for anything that was done. However, it seems like your white guilt is looking kinda nasty there. I would get that checked out.
We singled out African Americans as inferior just by their looks. You see? It's not much different now, is it?
It is completely and totally different. It's different in just more ways than I don't even... Where would I even start? I mean, it's bad enough this entire video was built around a concept that doesn't exist. The idea that people who are playing on PC think people who play on consoles are, on a moral level, lesser human beings. And that's obviously ridiculous. PC gamers and console gamers are all gamers. They play games. They don't play games together because... Well, that's how it works between the systems and the networks and all that stuff. PC gamers don't normally play with console gamers. There is a real, actual divide in the communities because they can't play together. Much like kids in a playground, people who play on consoles have their sandbox, and then we have like a Chuck E. Cheese with strippers. And you redeem the tokens for blowjobs. Plus, choosing to play on PC and choosing to play on console are just that. They are choices. They are things that you can influence. Your race is not something you have any control over. You don't choose to be white, black, yellow, green, red, orange, pink, green, aquamarine. Your race is just what you are, not to be confused with who you are. One is a choice, one is not. One is the actual belief that one race is superior and better than another race. One is saying, well, we can run games better than you, and we think we exist on a better platform than you for video gaming. Like, it's almost hard to think of differences because they're just so miles apart.
Yeah, we singled them out just like how PC gamers single out console gamers.
You're acting as if acknowledging differences in things is inherently bad. That's basically the exact parallel that you're trying to draw. Just because you recognize that things in some way, shape, or form fall into different categories doesn't mean that you're discriminating against them. You just recognize that two things are different. We all belong to the same community of gamers, but we are split into two different sub-communities where we play together. This effect is compounded by exclusives and the fact that you don't have a lot of multi-platform games that are cross-play.
We do. And we did, that's what I mean. We don't...
Nice Freudian slip. Most of us don't think about race like that, so...
Hopefully we don't do that anymore. I mean, I know we do.
No, we do not. Do not speak for anyone on this earth other than yourself. Don't make me part of a group like that by default.
But hopefully you don't. I mean, I don't.
It's sad to see we live in a world where people feel the need to tell people they're not racist. I assume that by default, people weren't racist.
But, yeah, that's what PC gamers do. Another thing is, they have an automatic bias towards console gamers, like how racism has an automatic bias against African Americans.
Well, what do you mean by automatic? Are you saying that in the same way that someone... I don't even get it. What is an automatic bias? The reason that I am biased, I guess, towards the PC and against consoles is because I understand them both very well. I know that one side has a massive list of advantages that the other side doesn't have. There are advantages and disadvantages on both sides, and the pluses definitely outweigh the negatives on the PC. There is a huge slew of reasons why I favor the PC and I play on the PC and not the consoles anymore. Again, this parallel is so far gone that I can't even think of a way to parallel it with racism, especially, what did you call it, automatic bias in the form of racism. I mean, when I was growing up, my parents never taught me about race. It was just assumed that I wouldn't treat races differently because they looked different. I don't know anything about this automatic bias. Maybe someone else could tell you more about it. I'm not a I'm not a socio-scientific person thing guy.
So at school, I know a couple PC gamers. Not going to list them.
Well, they sound like a bunch of racists to me.
They're constantly bragging about how they're superior.
How their platform is superior. How their experience is superior. How they have knowledge that you don't have. I highly doubt they're walking around and going up to people and saying, I'm physically a better human being than you on every level because I play on PC.
Now, I know that some people take PC Master Race as satire, and I don't mind the people who do that, people who realize that it's retarded.
No, satire isn't retarded. It's just satire. It's a joke. It's a gag. It's a running gag at this point. For those of you unaware, it comes from an old 2011 video done by Yahtzee on the channel Escapist. It's a impressions video on The Witcher.
It's stupid. In fact, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think that slogan was originally invented and created as satire, as a way to mock these people.
What quickly becomes obvious is that Witcher is very much a PC-exclusive game, which are typically designed to be as complex and unintuitive as possible so that those dirty console-playing peasants don't ruin it for the glorious PC gaming master race. The first warning sign is that the manual is thick enough to beat goats to death with, and then once you get into the game, the interface is just a few steps shy of Microsoft Access in terms of friendliness. There's your inventory screen, your character screen, your alchemy screen, your glossary, your quests, your map, you have to switch between combat mode and stand around picking your nose while enemies carve you like turducken mode, and once you're in combat mode, do you fight in strong, fast, or group style? And if you'll be wanting to mix potions, then I hope you've gone through the necessary 8-week correspondence course. If disliking this sort of shit makes me stupid, then call me retard McSpacky Pants, but I'd rather be stupid and having fun than bored out of my huge genius mind.
But the people who take it seriously, I know a couple of them at school, and they do. I have been mocked just because I'm a console gamer.
I mean, my heart bleeds for you. No, wait, no it doesn't, because you think I'm racist. Look, what the kids tell you at school, it doesn't matter. They're kids at school. Who cares what they say? Did your parents never tell you sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me? Because mine did. I don't let things people say bug you. It's ridiculous. Besides, maybe it goes to show that only little kids would go around legitimately making fun of people just because they play on console. If you think that the people who are the subjects of the response videos that I do are all exclusively console gamers, you're wrong. I don't care what system you play, if you say dumb things, that makes you a target for criticism.
Not on one occasion, but on more than one.
More than one?
You should build a PC. Sell your PS4. Why own one? Just build a PC. And be sure not to buy one, build one. It's like, get out of my business.
Wait, that's your definition of being mocked? Someone saying, he's giving you good advice. He's saying you should build a PC because it's not difficult and it's easy. And that's mocking? It's like, hey dude, I heard you have cancer. Have you considered chemotherapy?
Stop mocking me!
And it's just like racism.
It's like, hey dude, I heard you have cancer. Have you considered chemotherapy? You know, because you're white?
Stop mocking me!
They have a bias against other races.
What does one say to this? These people are giving me advice. They're saying I should build a PC, not necessarily buy one, but build one, and I should get rid of my weaker system because obviously you're not going to need it after you go to the PC. How is that like racism in any way? It's like, hey, I heard your best friend was black, but have you considered maybe having a white best friend? I would say an Asian best friend, but they're just out of your league. See, how ridiculous does that sound? This video's stupid. I don't even know if I'm gonna finish this. This is dumb. Man, I went and I put the fucking armband on the dog and I got the hat and it...
PC gamers have a bias against other gamers, them being console gamers.
Like, who they associate with? Well, outside of a gaming scenario, obviously we don't have a problem, like, being friends with people who don't play on PC, but in terms of video games, obviously we're gonna be friends with other PC gamers because those are the people we actually play with. We're not biased against console gamers in that respect, it's because we cannot play video games with those people. I mean, why the hell don't I just play Tiddlywinks with some guy in Mozambique? Because it's physically impossible to do. I went to my neighbor and said, hey, let me twiddle your winks. Well, maybe I wouldn't say it like that, but we could play the game. Also, both my neighbors are black, so they have big winks to twiddle.
So that's another reason why it's like racism. And the third is probably the biggest one.
You said biggest one.
And this isn't just for Civil War times and against African Americans.
Well, I mean, African American is not a race, it's a nationality. You can be 100% African American and be white as freshly fallen Canadian snow. Any race can be the target of racism. Whites, blacks, Hispanics, everybody. Everybody can be a target of racism.
This also applies to World War freaking II. They believe themselves to be the superior race.
PC players considered themselves the master race in World War II times?
Now let's go back to World War II.
Yeah, notice how there's a trend here with this kind of talk. You always have to go back in time, you see.
What did Adolf Hitler and the Germans and the Nazis at the time believe themselves to be compared to the Jews?
Well, Nazis and Germans are not the same thing, but go ahead.
Not only superior individuals, because they have different religious and different lifestyle beliefs, but also they considered themselves to be different blood and a superior race.
Wow, I've never heard of this Adolf Hitler guy. He sounds really mean. Why would... I mean, Nazis don't sound any good, and Adolf Hitler sounds kind of like a smarmy cunt. I mean, you'd have to be a pretty bad, horrible, terrible, awful human being to be compared to, you know, Hitler and the Nazis.
It's in the freaking name, PC Master Race, people!
Yeah, but when Hitler was talking about the Master Race, he wasn't joking around. He meant that shit. I heard some people died. And names aren't everything. I mean, I'm pretty sure when the Susan G. Coleman Race for the Cure lines up in the street, it's not just white people in the race, it's not just black people, it's not just Asians in that race. I mean, Race for the Cure, which Race for the Cure? Not all of them, surely. That's madness. Races working together in a modern society? No, preposterous. Poppycock.
They obviously consider themselves to be a superior race.
Obviously, PC gamers are Nazis. It's obvious. After all, you can't deny it. The similarities, it's stunning. Dear Lord, at this point, I feel like atheism is unstoppable, making kind of a stupid regressive The Young Turks video. Just change the phrase PC gamers are racist to white people are racist, and bam.
So yes, it is just like racism.
It's nothing like racism in any way.
It is. You cannot deny it. It is.
I mean, it's like telling someone who thinks the PS4 is stronger than the Xbox One, which is objectively true, that he's like a racist because he can acknowledge that he plays on a better console in terms of its objectively measurable power. I mean, you can apply this reasoning to preferring anything over anything else. Oh, you're saying skim milk is better for you because it has less fat in it than whole milk? Well, that's just like Hitler.
And it's sad. This is what gaming has come to.
In your mind and your mind alone.
This is what gaming has come to. Not, hey, let's get together, have a LAN party, maybe do some co-op, you know, let's have fun. It's come down to racism.
Oh yeah, every time me and the guys get together and we play DayZ or Dirty Bomb or Battlefield, we just can't shut up about how much we hate the Negro. Don't get me started on the Hispanics and the Asians. Oh, they're the worst. No, who's really worst is the white people we don't like. Because we're like Hitler, so not all white people are okay, just some white people. The white people are sneaky because you can't just tell at a glance which is a good white and which one's a bad white. Holy shit, I just gave people who hate me the golden sarcophagus of cherry picking, didn't I? Good thing it's satire!
That's what gaming has come down to, in terms of PC gamers and console gamers.
Yeah, every time someone from YouTube wants to send me a friend request, I say, well, you have to go to Google Docs and fill out this document. I need a photo ID, and you have to tell me what race you are, right? And the photo ID is there to prove that you're not lying. I don't want people telling me that they're white and they're not really white, okay? I don't need any of that sneaky Jew nonsense. Oh, and definitely no Catholics. Can't have them. No Jews. No Catholics. Mormons are okay, but they still have to watch themselves. Asians, out of the question. Unless they're Japanese. Then I'll let them pass. And if you're from any part of the world south of Texas, ugh, don't waste either of our time. Oh, and don't even get me started on the women.
It's not just we have different tastes, it's race.
I don't know about that. Asians and white people taste the same to me.
I know we have console wars, PS3 versus Xbox 360, but none have I ever seen just to be so bitter and mean-spirited and cold-hearted.
But again, when the PlayStation 4 gamers look at an Xbox One and they can see it's objectively weaker in its power, then how come they're not literally Hitler when they say that we play on a better system because ours is objectively stronger? How come they're not literally Hitler and I'm literally Hitler? How come I have to be Hitler? I'm always Hitler. I'm sick of being Hitler. I'm done. I'm finished. Someone else can be Hitler this time. No, I was Hitler last time. I'm not going to be Hitler again. Hell yeah, I'll be Stalin.
This isn't going to all PC gamers. This isn't going to the PC gamers who know that this is stupid and only take it as a joke or satire. This is going to those narcissistic, egotistical douchebags.
Yeah, but that could be anybody. You think people just giving you advice is harassment, it's mocking. Why would we trust you on who's who? As far as I'm concerned, you mean everybody, because you could say that everybody's a douchebag because all of them could possibly offer you advice.
Who think that just because, oh, I have an awesome gaming rig, look at me, that they're automatically better than console gamers.
Nobody thinks that. This whole video is built on a faulty premise.
Let me tell you something. Get it through your skulls. You might know how to build a great PC, a great rig that kills any console on the market, but does that make you a better person?
Well, I mean, it gives them another skill that they know that you don't, so that kind of makes them better in a way, in a utilitarian way. It doesn't mean they're more valuable as a human being, though.
Hell no. And does that make you someone to criticize people who don't want to follow your stupid rules? No, it doesn't.
Yeah, it does. I can criticize whatever, whoever, and however many things I want. Nothing is above criticism. Nothing. Not a single thing in the universe is above criticism.
It doesn't at all. And what you're doing, if you do it, is racism.
Yeah, criticizing somebody else's choice of entertainment is equal to racism. That's ridiculous. Crying false racism like this does nothing but harm, especially when you consider that there are actual racist things going on somewhere in the world. When you cry racism at every little tiny, silly, non-existent problem that exists, it just takes away from the urgency of the real issues.
It's racism in gaming form. I'm Kablam Bandicoot 64, and yes, my enter commentary is still in the works, people.
Oh goody, I'll make sure to miss it. That makes me a racist. I wouldn't want to be a racist by not watching your commentary, because there are other commentaries that are better. Saying that I like somebody else's commentary instead of your commentary because theirs is better and more well-informed, that basically makes me the racist of people who listen to commentaries. I'm literally Hitler. Sieg Heil! And of course, since this is YouTube, I have to put a disclaimer that I do not endorse Nazism or support Adolf Hitler in any way, shape, or form. But the man could rock a stash.